great to see everybody. Thank you guys for coming out today. Day one, really, of training camp. Practice will start tomorrow. So excited for the next month, getting to have our training camp here at our beautiful facility in front of our great fans. I think we have a really tight schedule that allows us to accomplish a lot of things as a football team, allow our team to compete for roles within our team, trying to maximize our personnel that we feel very good about. And then knowing that regular season and the 17-week grind is coming, we have a lot of work to do to prepare our team in addition to the competition phase that really gets going tomorrow. Just building our football identity, but building this year's version of our team, which each and every year it's going to be different. We're always going to stay true to what we believe in our football philosophy. Very important that the culture we established within this building in year one not only reaches that level, but goes well beyond that, because we found out in a lot of different ways how much that can affect winning, when it's a powerful, powerful, positive thing in the building. So me personally, going into year two, I feel like I've learned an incredible amount. I'm so fortunate to have our coaching staff and our personnel group and everybody involved in this building that helps make our organization what it is. I feel honored to be able to lead this group, and no better time of the year for me. Training camp's one of my favorite things. It's my favorite thing because of what takes place on the field. It's what takes place in the stands, seeing kids get to come out and see their favorite players up close and personal, watching them work every day. It's something I remember from my childhood that had such an impact on me. So it's always something that's very special. In addition to that, I just love the fact that we're going to have 2 weeks of joint practices. I love the fact that we, get to experience really football in its purest form. So beyond that, without me going too nostalgic on you, I will give you guys just a couple updates before we get practice underway tomorrow. You guys probably saw some of the transactions as far as Andre Carter being on PUP, sustained a soft tissue injury training this summer. Hopefully that's something we could pull him off of, in the not too distant future and have him start practicing. Chris Reed sustained a non-football injury away from the facility, lower leg injury. We're hoping that he's not that far behind Andre to be able to get going. But outside of those two guys a couple of the new guys that we just signed recently that will get up to speed, all others are healthy and ready to go. Brian O'Neill will not be on PUP, but we will continue kind of a predetermined plan for him that allows him to really progress towards the ultimate goal, which has always been September 10th against the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. So there'll be a process throughout camp. I'll try to keep you guys updated on not only his day-to-day, but where he's at. But the one thing I would just say is really all of the players that the last time I talked to you guys that were dealing with things, injuries, working through the rehab process, all of our players knocked it out of the park this summer. Guys have had great off seasons and really putting the stamp on what we do here from a standpoint of trying to get players healthy and at their best. And Brian kind of led the charge on that. So he's had a really good off season as well. But all others will be healthy and ready to go. So with that, I'll turn it over to you guys.
Kevin, you say all others. Is Danielle Hunter in camp, and do you expect him to participate?
Yeah, Danielle has reported. He's going through that process right now. It's going to be a day-to-day thing where, Danielle and I have had such good dialogue over these last few days and really trying to build a plan for him that allows him to feel good about, coming to work as a Minnesota Viking every single day. And we'll continue to work through the contractual side. I tend to, let that be dealt with Kwesi and Rob and the rest of our crew that do a great job with that. But, as always, and I try to keep the dialogue and the communication with all of our players open at all times. And I think Daniil feels comfortable communicating with me and we'll work through it day by day. But he is here. It was great to see him a few minutes ago.
Will he practice?
As of right now, we'll take it a day at a time. I don't expect him to initially be a full practice participant off the bat. We haven't really seen him since last season, and he looks great. He looks like he's Daniil Hunter, as always. But we'll work through a process there and really use this acclimation process to be smart about our entire roster.
What do you mean to have him here? I mean, obviously there was a lot of talk that he might have been a holdout.
Yeah.
Does it say something about him, say something about the team?
Yeah, I think through my dialogue with him, not only, you know, over the last few days, but throughout the offseason and really last season, Daniil Hunter loves the Minnesota Vikings. He loves his teammates. He feels really strongly, about Mike Smith as his position coach and what we're maybe trying to do defensively with Flo. But there's, you know, I'd be naive to not know that there's another part of that process, which is the business side of things. And I'm 100% understanding and know that those things tend to play out. And my role in all this is to make sure from a football standpoint that we are ready to roll. And all of our players, whenever they're capable, either coming off of an injury or whatever the issue may be that keeps them from the field early on, my role is to make sure that our football team's at their best when it's time to play the Bucs on the 10th. So that's what I'm focusing on. But like I said, it was great to see him. I think it'll mean a lot for his teammates to see him. And we'll just take it a day at a time from there and have a really productive training camp as a football team.
Kevin, how did you handle Jordan Addison's situation with him?
Yeah, we both Kwesi and myself have talked with him multiple times since. I was disappointed, but it was a mistake, and I think he's obviously owning that mistake and knows that's something that can't happen again. And Jordan has had a really good offseason, coming off of the temporary setback he had in the spring. We asked him to do a lot this summer to be prepared and at his best when we got going, and this was a mistake that happened. He's a rookie, and you'd love to say that, no mistakes like that are ever going to happen. But the big thing for me talking to Jordan was, let's learn from it. Let's make sure we're moving forward the right way. And I think he's got a good perspective on owning it, taking responsibility, but also moving forward the right way.
Yeah, but what would it mean for him to have Jay as a mentor, kind of see what he does in all facets of being a professional receiver?
Yeah, I think it's going to be huge. Just knowing that he's learning from the best player at the position he plays in football, watching him work every day, what JJ does on Sundays and throughout the season speaks for itself. But what a lot of people don't get to see is the way the guy works, the way, you know, he is in meetings, the way he collaborates with myself or Kirk or Wes on and Keenan on what we're doing offensively. Just the overall feel of JJ as a pro. And how important it is for him to prepare the right way and give himself the opportunity to go out there at US Bank and do the special things that he does. I think that'll be great for Jordan. I think it'll be great for him to be around KJ. I think it'll be great for him to be around Jalen Naylor, a guy that just went through his rookie year learning our system and kind of the ebbs and flows that Jalen went through from a year ago. And collectively having Keenan in that room, I know I sleep really well at night having a coach like that played 17 years, played the position, did it a lot of ways at a really high level for a long time. So I feel really strong about that receiver grouping and just excited to get that group and really our whole group as a whole out there on the grass together working to build our offense for this year.
Given the citation of the police file there, that it said that Jordan told them that he was going home because there was an emergency with his dog. Is that the explanation that he gave you, or did he give you an explanation for why he was driving so fast?
We talked about that, and he mentioned that, and really what I was focused on was, Kevin, was more of, you know, the making sure he knew exactly that it was a serious thing, and he needs to make sure he understands just exactly what he did wrong, and then go back and, in some of these circumstances, the why behind things is it's important, but understanding that no matter what the why may be, things like that can't happen again, regardless of whatever may have caused him to drive that fast. It's just not something that can happen again. And I think he's always been a guy through the whole draft process and getting to know him and his family and everything. I have a 100% confidence in Jordan. That he's obviously going to have a great camp, but I still feel very strongly about the type of person and player we added to our team.
Specifically, are you going to ease him in, or is he going to be a full participant since you said he's healthy?
Yeah, but the plan of attack right now is he'll be a full participant. What that looks like repetition-wise, you know, will be a day-to-day thing, but he will take part in, you know, every period of practice tomorrow.
As you think about his potential role, like, how much responsibility do you think he will have in the job?
Yeah, you know, Alec, I think it's something where we don't really have to answer that question right now. All we can do, much like, you know, rookies from a year ago or the other rookies in this year's class, we want them, you know, to just have a laser focus of every single day. Don't look beyond just tomorrow. Make sure you're physically prepared, which he's done the work to do. But then mentally, there's still a lot. We're going to be moving quicker. I mean, Kirk and Justin and you know, Alex and TJ, these guys have been in the system now. So with that first group, we're going to be moving pretty quickly. That's their expectation. That's what they want. And we'll give him opportunities every single day to be in the huddle with that group. And then it's just a kind of a daily awareness of where he's at mentally, but making sure technique, fundamentals, the physical side of playing the position, the growth we're looking for, you know, that's something that we can help him with every single day. And then the personal responsibility of, you know, making sure he's absorbing the playbook and can go take it to the grass, because physically gifted player, we're excited about him, very, very excited about him. And now we get to see the process play out, you know, on a daily timetable where we're trying to maximize every single day.
Daniil, is his contractual stuff going to need to be resolved before he's a full participant?
Yeah, Kevin, I would just say the details on that, you know, I would defer to Kwasion, but, you know, with him more than likely, you know, not being a full participant in practice off the bat, you know, there's some things we still have to kind of determine and iron out, and that'll be something that will be an ongoing thing.
As far as the guy that shows up and basically now, I think it's called a hold in, Kevin, but what's your approach as a coach with a guy who's a key player? You're glad to see him here, but then he's not practicing, he's not really hurt. Like, what's your take on this?
Yeah, the key to me is the dialogue between myself as the head coach and the player, and making sure they know exactly my mindset, you know, big picture, but also making sure, like I'm going to ask our whole entire team to do, taking a day-to-day focus and what that looks like. It can change, it can evolve based upon, you know, what Daniil and I discuss is the best thing for him. And the starting point was he showed up today, and he's, you know, around his teammates, and he's in our building. And that's day one, and we'll kind of move forward from here with a positive mindset that, you know, hopefully Daniil Hunter is playing every single game for us this year and having a major impact like he's done his whole career here. So I think just keeping the focus on the day-to-day and understanding, although training camp is a finite amount of time to prepare for our season, we also want to make sure Daniil feels 100% comfortable and is excited about that as well.
Use training camp at all, just in case you think he might not be active week one, or are you not thinking that far?
I don't think you, just with how the reps go and the development, I know I throw that word around a lot, but the development of making sure that entire position group and all of our players for the depth of our team, I think you see it every year in the NFL. The more you can develop the depth of your team, while also building your football identity and making sure that your players you're going to try to hang your hat on and really lean on for their leadership and their production are getting the work that they need to be prepared. And, you know, we've got a veteran quarterback who knows very detailed of how he needs to go about his training camp to prepare. And we've got other players we're really relying on that we have relied on that know as well. And I lean on those guys to kind of help lead that charge. And once again, it is not a cliche in training camp. If you start worrying about next Friday or joint practices right now, we're not going to be doing our due diligence on the early part of camp to make sure we earn the right to just get a little bit better every single day and keep the arrow up on this football team and a positive momentum that we can be where we want to be come September 10th.
I think a lot of people's eyes were opened in the Netflix documentary, but the pressure and the physical toll on Kirk last year. How much emphasis is there going to be in this year's iteration of the offense to reduce or mitigate the hits that he takes?
Yeah, I think it all goes back to a big picture look when myself and our offensive staff really peeled back the layers on what we really were. We were We were a successful offense last year. We moved the ball. We scored points. We were at our best in many moments when it was required at the end of games to go try to get that done. But there is a lot of room for improvement for our football team and specifically our offense. Looking at, you know, things like efficiency, how do we stay on track? How do we avoid negative plays? How do we make sure we are staying true to who we want to be and running the football and building an offense around running the football and having a layer of physicality we can hang our hat on. I'm excited about our personnel that we've added, the personnel that's back, giving me some real think tank time to kind of put together a this year's version of our offense. It may jump out to our fans and you guys. It may be subtle little things here and there, but I feel very good about what we're planning to do and what we're planning to implement. And now we got to go do it. It's one thing to put it on paper. It's one thing to think about it and talk about it. It's great. Nobody loves a chalkboard and a marker more than me, but now you got to go coach it and your players got to own it. And we feel very strongly about our ability to have it all come together.
Can we get your thoughts on the running back market? And just speaking on how important these guys are, because when you look around the NFL, some guys are holding out, some guys are getting paid, and some guys are not. What are your thoughts as a head coach and a former player about that position and what they mean to a team?
First and foremost, as a head coach, there's not one player on our team that I value more than others based upon their role. I can't really speak specifically to the rest of the league and how they view it. I know there's probably maybe 32 different answers to that question. I just know how important that position is and that role is in a lot of ways in our offense. And I feel really good about the group that we have. I'm excited to see Alex Madison in that lead role. And there's going to be some great competition throughout behind him with guys we're really excited about. And part of being more efficient is and hanging your hat in the run game is building that position up. And it comes on the pass downs as well. Protection, versatility in the pass game. There's a lot of things that go into it. But I know my focus is that's a major part of our offense, major part of how we want to move the football. And we're expecting a lot of good things out of that group.
Thanks, everybody. We'll wait
to you right up. You good? I have a feeling you guys will get to talk to me a lot over the next month and a half.
Appreciate all you guys.